Hello all, and welcome to another What's What. We are very excited to jump back into things here at the studio. And there is no time to waste. So tell me, can you spot a battery in this photo? I see the lake, but wait, does that lake feed into something? That's it, there, a giant battery that makes this not a lake nor any reservoir, but a PHES, that is Pumped Hydroelectric Energy Storage. For those who don't know, we are going to break this down and more in this episode. But before we get started, don't forget to like and subscribe below. Before we get into how pumped hydroelectric energy storage facilities operate, let's make some distinctions regarding dispatchable and variable power stations. Dispatchable stations, which create water vapor from nuclear or gas energy, are able to maintain a balance between consumption and generation. Variable stations, on the other hand, such as wind or solar, depend on the goodwill of Mother Nature. Meaning lack of wind or sun can disrupt the balance and lead to a variety of risk. An additional solution is electricity storage. And luckily, pumped hydroelectric energy storage is at the forefront of this ever-expanding technology. Pumped hydroelectric energy storage represents about 94% of global energy storage, with lithium ion and other batteries making up the other 6%. Pumped hydroelectric energy plants are like hydroplants, but not like hydroplants. Let's take a look at the standard layout. It consists of two separate water reservoirs at different elevations. Water moves from one to the other, passing through a turbine in what we call a discharge. Again, this is standard for any hydropower system, but what separates hydroelectric energy storage plants are their ability to return water to the upper reservoir in what we call a recharge via an electric pump. So, during periods of high demand, stored water is released through turbines to produce electric power. Whereas during off-peak hours, electric power is used to push water back into the reservoir, using energy to store energy. Seems kind of contradicting, doesn't it? In fact, it's not, because against losses due to pumping, pumped hydroelectric storage allows grid operators to increase revenue by selling more electricity during peak demands. With that being said, these systems cannot operate without the help of another natural phenomenon, gravity. Due to gravity or the Earth's attraction, these systems hold water in their upper reservoir and are subject to energetic pull. Kinetic energy is manifested once that water goes into motion. Like, for example, when water is released into a penstock pipe. During its descent, gravitational energy turns into kinetic energy. When the water flow reaches a turbine, an alternator rotor then transforms kinetic energy into rotational energy. That's one, two, and three modifications of energy, all in one place. Pumped hydroelectric systems are no joke. Reciprocally, electrical energy consumed by the pump motors donates gravitational energy to push water back to the reservoir. So it all comes around. And with this, renewable energy takes dual meaning. Get it? It's renewable and renewable. Never mind. So, now that we know basic layouts and operational functions, what about the size of pumped hydroelectric reservoirs and how much energy they provide? Take a facility with two reservoirs, each roughly the size of an Olympic swimming pool, add a 500 meter differential between them. This layout would provide 4 megawatts of power and store up to 3.5 megawatt hours of electricity. That's enough to say supply a high-speed train at full power. Not bad, right? Not bad at all. Now, let's take a look at some history and see how the system affects our energy circulation. The first known pumped hydroelectric energy storage facilities were built in Switzerland and Italy during the 1890s, and 40 years later, the United States followed. Way back, hydroelectric power was synonymous with gigantic dams. But later, pumped hydroelectric energy storage systems have taken a new turn, manipulating gravity and water to create energy with more modest infrastructures, allowing technology to rapidly expand. And nowadays, you can find these facilities all over the world. Let's use the United States of America as a case study. There, the cumulative generation capacity of pumped hydroelectric energy storage stations lands at about 22 gigawatts, which equals 22 traditional nuclear power reactors. The country's associated storage capacity runs in at 550 gigawatt hours, which in comparison could supply more than 18 million residential citizens for a day. As you can see, these facilities are serious means for energy supply. No energy technology can even compete. Let's do a quick recap before we wrap things up. Pumped hydroelectric energy storage, PHES, represents about 94% of global energy storage. What separates PHES facilities from other hydro plants is their modest layout and dual reservoir system. Because of this, PHES systems also have the ability to pump and store energy in the form of water. And with their ability to store renewable energy, PHES facilities are elite in regards to renewable energy storage and distribution. So, that about wraps up our episode on PHES facilities. And with more than 100 projects coming down the pipeline, it is estimated that pumped hydropower storage will see a 50% increase by the year of 2030. Think of the energy to be stored, shared, and all without emissions during operation. Do you have any thoughts of PHES systems? Any ideas on how to take them to the next level? Feel free to drop a comment below. Thanks again for tuning in. I'm Frederick from What's What. Until next time.